Let's see if we can get some experience converting from a decimal representation to a binary, And let's start with a fairly straightforward example, with a fairly low number. Let's see if we can convert the number 13 in decimal to binary. And I encourage you to pause the video and try to work through it out on your own. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it. So the key here is to see if you can deconstruct the number 13 as the sum of powers of 2. And then it becomes very straightforward to represent it in binary. Because in binary, you're essentially saying, well, what powers of 2 do you need to make up this number? And so let's just write the powers of 2 here, just to remind ourselves. And I'll go until we go right above 13. So 2 to the 0 is equal to 1. 2 to the 1st is equal to 2. 2 squared is equal to 4. 2 to the 3rd is equal to 8. 2 to the 4th is equal to 16. And I'm above 13. So I'm definitely, I have all the powers of 2 that I need to construct 13. So what's the largest power of 2 that is less than or equal to 13? Well, 16 is too large. Well, it would be 8. So I could rewrite 13 as 8 plus 5. Now 5 is not a power of 2, so I have to keep deconstructing that. What's the largest power of 2 that is less than or equal to 5? We see it right over here, it's 4. So let me rewrite that. It's 8 plus, instead of writing 5, I'll write 4 plus 1. And then the good thing is, 1 as a power of 2, we already see the largest power of 2 that's less than or equal to it is 1. This already is a power of 2. So I've now rewritten this as the sum of powers of 2. Notice this is 2 to the 3rd, whoops. This is 2 to the 3rd power. This is 2 squared. And this is 2 to the 0 power. Or I could write it like this. I have 1, 8. I have 1, 8 clearly. I have 1, 4. 1, 4. And I have 1, 1. So I could add these two. I could add these three together. 13 could be considered 1, 8 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 1. Well, why is that helpful? Well, now let's go into binary mode and think about what each of the place values represent. So this is the ones place. That's the ones place. And then we could go to the twos place. Twos place. Every time we go to the left, each place we multiply by 2. It's the next power of 2. Then we go to the fours place. Fours place. And then we go to the eights place. Eights place. Eights. And in binary, I only have 2 digits, 0 or 1. So I either have 0 of a place or I have 1 of it. So let's go through it. How many ones do I have? Well, I have 1, 1. So I write that there. How many 2s do I have? Well, in this representation, I don't have any 2s the way I've written. I have an 8, I have a 4, and a 1. So I'm going to put I have 0 2s. How many 4s do I have? Well, I have 1, 4. 1, 4. And how many 8s do I have? Well, I have 1, 8. So 13, the 13 written in decimal, or 13, which is a decimal number, if I were to write it in binary, is 1101.